Welcome! In this tutorial we will learn the procedures for illumination of a single and both main tank fuel pump low pressure lights. Procedures shown may not be current or airline specific. Do not use for real life flying. While flying along, our attention is drawn to the illuminated low pressure light on the fuel panel. If applicable, the QRC is scanned to see if the procedure we need is on it, followed by looking in the Quick Reference Handbook, or QRH. The procedure can be found in the index, under both fuel pump low pressure, and also low pressure fuel pump. Once the procedure is opened, the first step is for the pilot monitoring to read the procedure title and condition and make sure both pilots are in agreement this is the correct procedure before continuing. This would sound like
fuel pump low pressure procedure, condition, the fuel pump pressure is low. Do you agree?
Once both pilots agree it is correct, the first step is performed. The procedure starts with a choice, depending whether one or both main tank fuel pump low pressure lights are illuminated. Looking at the panel, we can see only one of the main fuel tank low pressure lights is illuminated, and no center fuel tank lights are lit, which would have taken us to a different place in the procedure. In the decision path, the applicable path is under the one main tank fuel pump low pressure light is illuminated, and the first step within this path has us turn off the main tank fuel pump switch on the affected side. As with all procedures, there is no need to rush, and care should be taken to follow the procedure accurately. We follow the procedure and turn off the forward fuel pump on the affected side. Returning to the procedure, the note can be read that sufficient fuel pressure is available for normal operation. The four black boxes let us know the procedure for one main fuel tank pump low pressure light being illuminated is now completed. We'll now take a look at the procedure for when both main fuel pump low pressure lights are illuminated. We pick the decision path for both lights, which contains an important note: at high altitude, thrust deterioration or engine flameout may occur. There are no steps to follow, and the procedure is shown to end by the four black boxes underneath. This would indicate a serious condition that would necessitate a descent if able. Please subscribe to learn of our future videos.